there's a curious lineup here, but there is a story behind each one.
You got the Whittle jet engine.
And next I got the Mini, and then the Moulton bicycle and the Citroen Maserati.
People at the Royal College were designing the casings of things. They were only concerned with design.
I saw that design should be part of engineering. It should be part of the whole process. It shouldn't be something that you do at the end to make something look good in order to sell it. That's quite unusual in thinking like that. It was a very exciting time of change. When I was realizing that design was engineering, it was one and the same thing, there were wonderful examples around. There were, of course, things like the Harrier jump jet out of the window there. It's really, really interesting. I mean, not only is it the first, I think it's the only vertical takeoff aircraft that actually works. It's right by our entrance hall. The missiles are pointing away from the entrance hall. And then, of course, there was the Mini, which wasn't an obviously styled car. How it looks was done by Isagenis, the engineer who did the engineering. I mean, it's a triumph of space, because it's 10 foot long. Their brief is to make it 10 foot long and 4 feet wide and however high it is, 4 feet high. And to do that, he had to put the engine at the front, a transverse engine and transverse gearbox, driving both the front wheels. Yes, I mean, Isagenis, I think he was given 10,000 engineers to design it. He said, I don't want 10,000 engineers, I want 2,000. He came with a prototype to show Jeremy Fry down at his house. And in this pocket here, he had a whole row of Gordon Gin's bottles. That was his tipple. And he said, look, you know, you can get 40 Gordon Gin bottles in the pocket. It came out in the very late 50s, 1959, I think it came out. And my mother bought one in the early 60s. It looked incredibly different. I mean, there'd been no car like this before. I mean, it drove brilliantly. It was impossibly small, yet huge inside. It's a good car. It's not too small. Alex Moulton did the suspension. That's the hydroelastic unit there. Very nice. And that actually brings me onto his bicycle, which is similar. And again, you know, no one had done a bike like this before. So when this came out in the 60s, he put very small wheels on it. And you have to pump the wheels up very hard. The only problem with small wheels is that you're more susceptible to bumps. You really feel the bumps. So he overcame that by having suspension. That suspension there and suspension unit here. It's quite an interesting bike because it has a central frame, but then the rear wheel is on one frame and the front wheels are on the front forks. Totally unlike a conventional bike. Now, this is a Citroen Maserati. What? It was really unusual at the time, because people weren't making aerodynamic cars. Starting from the front, it had swivelling headlights. I think that one swiveled. It's done by string round pulleys, working off the steering column. And it was the first car to do that. I mean, you can see its styling is still pretty flashy. Still quite contemporary. Let's go inside it. There, see, that's a good old Maserati engine. I don't know if you noticed, I didn't slow down for that speed bump. You don't have to slow down for speed bumps. It just doesn't notice them because it has hydropneumatic suspension. And it's so good that when you hit a bump or something, you just don't feel it. Now, here we got the Whittle jet engine, the oldest running jet engine in the world. Frank Whittle was extraordinary. He had this extraordinary vision about what he wanted a jet engine for, but also he got everything right first time. And I mean, no one does that, but Whittle did it. And our engineers rebuilt the fuel system to Whittle's original drawings, and it works perfectly.
We are running at about 5,000 RPM, and it will go up to 20,000. As I said earlier, what's it achieved? But it started first time, and it's tired.
You can hear the power, that power of it. You know, that's air noise. It's this huge fan, a turbine turning round. It's amazing, any one moving part.
You realize that these are engineering icons. They're famous British inventions and breakthroughs. Inventing, engineering, designing, and art are inseparable. And it brings life to the place.